Start.
Good morning, students. Today we are going to see the subject of theory of computation. What is the theory of computation? All the languages, computer languages, for example, C, C++, Java, or maybe the language, we want to check the syntax of the language. For example, you take another variable. The variable, we have the roots. That means it starts with the letter, then followed by letter or maybe digits. Number of times it may differ. So here, how we can check? With the help of machine. The machine can be constructed by using theory of computation. How we can construct the machine? Or we can say some machine name, that means the finite element. This name is called as FA shortly. It further classified different two types. One is NFA, another one is VA. So what is NFA? NFA is a non-deterministic finite element. Then second one is DF, deterministic finite element. Non-deterministic finite element is for a single input, it may host one or more steps. One or more steps. For example, deterministic finite element, for the single input, it may go to the single statement. So that's why it's a deterministic. And another one is, another difference between NFA and DFA is, the NFA support the epsilon transition. And another, DFA does not support the epsilon transition. So unit transition. So these can be, so it is a machine. So what's the language it can be derived in? So this called as RL. RL stands for regular language. Regular language means what? We have some rules. For example, regular language may have the regular expressions. So expressions, suppose there are four rules. One is a concatenation. Okay, concatenation. Then second one is we have the union operation. That means the clean closure operator. Clean closure operator. Clean closure. Then positive closure. This is zero or more tens of atoms. Zero or more tens of atoms. This is positive closure. Positive closure may act as one or more tens. One or more tens. That is the concatenation. Then we have the what? Clean closure, then positive closure, and finally we have the R operation. That is A or. It can be denoted by slash or sometimes some notation is the form of S. Okay. Now we can have some example from the regular expression. That is A dot B. This is A, then followed by B. This is concatenation. Definitely it starts with the A. Okay, then it followed by B. Okay. Then A slash B. What does the A slash B mean? It's a union of. That means A may. Yeah, input is A or it B. A or B. A or B. It may read the A, it reads the final state, or it reads the B, it goes to the final state. Okay. Then A star. The A star is a A clean closure, already I told that it is a clean closure, zero or more. That means it is a set which consists of epsilon, then A, then A, A, then 2, then 7. Likewise, it's one. Then A plus A positive closure. A positive closure means without epsilon. That means A, then A, then triple tens of A, likewise it is going on. So the A plus can be rewritten in terms of A plus is equal to A star, then difference of epsilon. So this is also okay. So we can see now. For example, we can see the corresponding regular expression into the corresponding NFA. We can see. Okay. For example, A dot B is the regular expression. Now we can construct the NFA machine. So NFA machine, we have consist of start state. Start state, that is denoted by the arrow mark. If in front of the arrow mark is missing, then it's a start state, Q naught. Then B is the A is read by the this state and it go to the Q1 state. Then similarly, it reads the Q1. Q1 reads the B state. It reads the Q2 state. So aid. Now, this is called as a financial. It is sample for the A bond. Similarly, A divided by B. A divided by B is a regular expression. The corresponding end of the emission or B of emission. If the star say Q, then it may go to the Q0, then Q1, it will be A. Then it is also final state. Then R, it will be the, it will be the B, it will go to the Q2 state. This is, there are two final state for A and B because it read the starting state and we read the A as input and go to the Q1 as the final state. Or A, Q0 as a starting state, read the B as input and go to the Q. This is A or B. So, for example, we consider now A star. A star is the what? Clean closure. What is the clean closure operator? Is it zero or more arguments? So we consider the finite emission. So star state is a Q naught. Then we have the read the epsilon. Then it goes to the Q1. Then from Q1 to Q2, it read the EA. Then Q3 is the final state. So it goes to the epsilon. So it's a final state. So you have the zero or more arguments. So it directly go to the Q0 to Q3, read the same input of epsilon, that is for 0 bits. If A has a 1 time means, it read the Q0 to Q1, Q1 to Q2, then Q2 to Q3. Now, the A can be occurrence of multiple times. So from Q2 to Q1, I can have the epsilon. Now, it may have the multiple times. So this is for N of A, finite element. So this N of A is useful to check the syntax.